Hello everyone, and welcome to our series of writing a high-performance web server in Rust. For this purpose, we will use one of the most popular Rust frameworks, Actix Web. In today's video, we will learn how to establish a MySQL database connection with our web server. MySQL is an open-source relational database management system. As with other relational databases, MySQL stores data in tables made up of rows and columns. Users can define, manipulate, control, and query data using structured query language, more commonly known as SQL. Its name is a combination of My, the name of co-founder Michael Wydenius's daughter My, and SQL, the acronym for structured query language. For our purposes, we will use a Rust library called SQLX. It is the Rust SQL Toolkit. An async, pure Rust SQL crate featuring compile-time checked queries without a DSL. Supports PostgreSQL, MySQL, and SQLite. Without wasting any further time, let's get started. Let us open our cargo.toml file and add SQLX as a dependency. We will use the latest version of SQLX with two features, namely MySQL and Runtime Tokio Native TLS. Now, let us create a new file in our source folder. Let us call this file database.rs. We will import MySQL pool from our SQLX library. We need to inform our project to use this file. Hence, we will import this file in our main.rs as a module. And then use it using use keyword. Now we will create a new function called database connection inside our database file. We will mark it public and async. From our database connection function, we will return a MySQL pool connected to our database. Let us call our database Actix Web. Our connect function, which is associated with MySQL pool, returns result on awaiting. Hence, we should update our database connection function to return result of MySQL pool and SQLX error. Let us use our database connection function inside our main function. Since our connection function returns a result, we will use expect to immediately terminate our application if our database connection function returns an error. Let us store this into new variable database. We will use print line macro in the next line, which will say database connection established. We need our application to be able to use this pooled connection inside our endpoints. Therefore, we will move our database variable to app data. Let us build and run our application using Cargo Run. We can see our terminal says database connection established and server running on localhost 8000. That's it for today. In the next video, we will CRUD over our application using SQLX. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you and visit again. Happy coding!